Good day, subscribers. It's me, the finance guy, and I've got a video for you guys today. Is it a video where you tell me all your deepest, darkest secrets? No, sorry. It's my stock pick of the week. So we're gonna be talking about a company that I've talked about on my channel and one of the advocations of why I think you shouldn't spend $6 at Starbucks. But I also want to tell you my perspective on a company that I think will do rather well in the future, even though it's had a little bit of bad rep right now. I purchased some shares of this company when it was on a little bit of a dip, and I kind of wanted to give you guys my perspective on the company and where it's going forward before we jump into it today. With that being said, I must advocate for you guys to make sure that you're spending your own money on things that you really enjoy. And as much as I would like, now that I'm a share owner of this company, for you to go out and spend money on Starbucks, I don't really advocate it as a really good way to save money. And I'm always going to advocate for you guys the best ways to get ahead financially, and going out and buying $6 coffees is not the best way to do that. The best way to get ahead financially is to probably brew your own coffee at home, do it like a little Mr. Coffee. That's what I do, and I do Folgers. But there's been the occasional time that I've slipped into Starbucks and I've purchased some coffee from the company, mostly during their holiday seasons. There's specific drinks that I kind of really like during the holidays, and I usually only get one, maybe two during the holidays as a special kind of treat to myself. With that being said, let's jump into it today and get started. All right, let's start with the PE ratio and see if there's ever been like a really good time or a better time to buy this stock based in the past like 10 years. All right, let's go back and see. Back in 2007, 35 PE. Oh, good point. Back in 2008. Let's see, another PE. 2010 was a good time to buy at 18 PE. It's actually had a pretty consistent high PE ratio for a decent amount of time, just because I think this is a pretty decent growth-based company. With that being said, it looks like right now it's back at 18.85 as of 2017 into 2018. It's at 18, hovering around the 18 PE ratio, which is a little expensive. Next, let's look and see if it's paying a dividend consistently on a very steady upward trend. All right, well, it seems like that the payout seems to be pretty decently. It's on an upward trend. That's something I always really like to see in a company, that it's increasing its dividend as time goes on and that it's consistent. And for what little time it's been around, it's doing pretty darn good. Let's see if this dividend increases as time goes by. Next, let's make sure that the revenue is on the uptrend and the company is growing its sales and doing well. All right, let's look at its past history as far as revenue is concerned. As time has gone on, it's on the increase. The only time that there was a little bit of a weird situation was back in 2013, 2014. Its net was less, but overall the revenue for this company has remained decently steady and on the increase. So I really like to see that in a stock. Next, let's look at the assets to liabilities, seeing if the debt is decreasing in time. Personally, I always like to see when a company is decreasing its debt, but as time goes on, businesses need to leverage their money more so that they can get ahead financially, so they can compete against their competitors. So sometimes you're going to accrue more debt in time, but ultimately I like to see debt decreased. All right, everything looks pretty standard here. As you can see, as time has gone by, the company has more assets than it does liabilities. And as time has also gone on, it's also increased its liabilities, something I really don't like to see. And it's picked up a decent amount of long-term debt right now. So we'll see how that pans out in the future. It's something I really don't like seeing. All right, let's look into the cash flow and make sure that it's going also on the steady uptrend. Is the company doing well? Are they bringing in consistent cash? And let's see if there's any kind of fluctuations as time goes by. All right, everything looks pretty normal, except for in 2013, there's going to be this weird dip that I don't really know about. And then it goes back to remaining consistently steady on its cash flow course. But apparently between 2013 and 14, there was some kind of weird dip. I'm curious to what you guys think about that and if you have any knowledge about why that was. And if you guys see any kind of anomalies, that's a good indicator to go do some more research. Next, let's look at the PB ratio and make sure that it's remaining at least decently steady or going down, or if it is below 3. All right, let's go back in history and see kind of where a good PB point was. Oh, back in 2009, it had less than a 3 PB ratio. And as time goes by, it looks like the PB ratio for this stock is actually worse and worse. Here towards the beginning of 2018, it's got a PB ratio of almost 17, which is just freaking awful. Next, let's look at the stock price and see if it's kind of on a dip or if it's a good, decent buy right now, and where's the stock been in the past 5 to 10 years? Alright, if we go way back, it was actually almost 50 cents a share. But as you can see, in 2006 to 2009, it hit a really low point, $4 a share almost.
This is why we invest into times of economic struggle.
And from there, the stock rallied almost from 2009 to 2015. And at 2015, the stock has remained pretty flat. It really hasn't gone anywhere since then, and it's remained so all the way into 2018. It just hasn't really gone any direction, which is rather strange because usually you want to see stocks really like go up in times of economic booms, and it's just really not doing that right now. It's remained rather flatlined. So we'll see where the direction of this company goes in the future. Next, let's look into the shares outstanding and make sure that it's on a decline. You want to see less shares because the less shares that are out there, the more value that those shares have. Okie dokie, looks like things have been going pretty decently steady and there's been less shares as time has gone on. That's something I really like to see. So in closing, what does that kind of really mean for Starbucks? It's kind of a mixed bag, a little bit of good stuff and a little bit of bad stuff. Where do you think the direction is going, you may be asking? And well, they're kind of working into China. The question is, can Starbucks build a coffee culture over there when they're kind of more focused on tea than they are on coffee? So if they can get China to really like coffee as much as the United States, honestly, Starbucks has excellent growth potential. But if they can't, and they start exposing themselves more into that foreign country without getting the love that Americans have on coffee, it might be a bit of a bust. So it's a little bit of a mixed bag, and that's why I think this stock holds a less than 2% of holdings in a portfolio. It's a minor position I think people should pick up on in this stock. Keep in mind, I'm not your financial advisor, and you can do your own research when it comes to investing. But I would not invest more than 2% of my holdings into Starbucks just because I think it's a little bit of a risky business to get into, and that's kind of why I think the company has remained rather flat for the past few years. Given that, I also think that the company could do really well in the future, especially if they can get the middle class in China to really like coffee. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Please subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Give me a like if you really liked the video today, guys. And feel free to comment down below. I really look forward to your comments. And hit the bell for more notifications. I make videos almost daily. Hope to see you again next time. Loving you is easy 'cause you're beautiful. Doo-doo-doo.